Today, we're going to look at the Tenable Vulnerability Management dashboards. Move your mouse to the top left-hand corner of the screen and you see the menu button. So click menu, hover over dashboards, or you can actually click dashboards. That also takes you to the dashboard menu, but you also have the option to click menu and then hover over and choose all dashboard, new from template and widget library. And we'll cover those in just a second. Now you have the two default dashboards here. So you can do the list view or the grid view. You see what I've done there. And this is the dashboard that you see when you first go into Tenable right here, the Vulnerability Management Overview Explorer, okay? Not to be confused with the Explorer Overview, right? So if you click on this one, this takes you to the dashboard that you're currently seeing here. And I'll go through this really quickly because one of the things I like about this dashboard is because it shows you, like, this is Nessus Scanner. And so we'll go into the details about the different type of scanners, but this is the Nessus Scanner that's scanning across the network. This is a network scanner. They scan it on your local network, or it can be scanning from the internet to your internet facing, whether it be web servers or application servers or anything that you're serving up that can be reachable for the internet, that shows up in this section. Here are your Tenable agents here in this section, and then your continuous assessment. And this is where you're going to have like your cloud infrastructure, so Tenable Cloud. And keep in mind, agents, this is software that's actually installed on the machine that's doing a vulnerability assessment on the host, okay? Now you also have right here the vulnerability priority rating. This is where Tenable takes additional information and they put that together with like the CVSS scores, and then they give you what they believe the rating of the vulnerability is. Just because it's a critical, it may not be exploitable, it may be difficult to exploit, it may require you to be local to exploit. And so that may, instead of it being a critical vulnerability, Tenable may rate it down here as a 6.9, which is, I would like equate that to be more of a medium severity vulnerability. So if you see 9 to 10, you can kind of associate that with critical. 7 to 8.9, you can associate that with high. 4 to 6.9, you can associate that with medium. And then 0 to 3.9, you can associate that with low. But just keep in mind, it's a separate rating system, so that's just kind of the way I view it, since they'd have four categories here. Now, SLAs, now I want to show you something specifically on dashboards. So you have not meeting SLA and meeting SLAs. So on any of these dashboards, you typically can click on them, and I'll show you here, and you can say, okay, what does this SLA mean? What does this really mean? So if you want to understand the true definition of the SLA, you click on the actual number there. And it takes you here. And what you want to look at is the query here. So just so you can kind of like get just an understanding of this and how to kind of get information, even if you don't know or if you never used it before, what you're looking at here is you see it has a VPR or vulnerability priority rating that's greater than or equal to 9. So 9 and above. So that would be 9 to 10. And it's first seen older than 7 days. So this is anything that's older, that would be 8 days, not, you know, 7, because that's actually equal to. So if it said greater than or equal to, but this says older than 7 days, right? So that's what's going to be considered the SLA. So not meeting the SLA as a critical, not meeting the SLA as a high, you click here, that's going to be a VPR that's greater than equal to 7, and a VPR that's less than equal to 9. So between 7 and 9, greater than and equal to. So 7 to less than 9. Anything not 9 itself, okay? And first seen older than 30 days. So that gives you a sense of what the SLAs are. And so you can use this to also assess vulnerabilities. Now, if you want my opinion of it, I can provide this and I can maybe do a short video to kind of tell you what I use. But I want you to be exposed to this because there are many ways to do vulnerability management. And I don't want you to get in the mode of just saying, okay, this one person recommended on YouTube, so that's the way I'm going to do it. But I will try to help give you a foundation so that you can know what you're doing and how you get started. And then you can use that to develop and build on your own system. This is very important, critical and high exploitable vulnerabilities. The main thing I want you to look at here is exploited by malware, remotely exploited with low complexity. Okay, so malware, remotely exploitable with low complexity, that's pretty serious because that means it doesn't take somebody with a high level of skill to exploit it, and they can do it over the internet or over the network, okay? Locally exploitable with low complexity, which means they have to be local to the machine to exploit it, but it's pretty easy to exploit. Metasploit, which means it has a Metasploit module that's available that can be used to exploit it. And then remotely exploitable with high complexity. So it can be done remotely, but it's hard to do. You also have this other widget, by the way, these are called widgets in Tenable Vulnerability Management, that allows you to see the future threats not yet exploitable. So you have some that are proof of concepts, and it shows how old these are, right? And so once again, you can click on these and you can look at the query and how Tenable comes up with these metrics on a dashboard, because learning these metrics can help you to develop your own dashboards in the future, right? So you want to learn what each of these categories means, because this is really valuable information, okay? So you can see the temporal vector is equal to EP. Now you say, what is the CVSS temporal vector? Well, that's why I'm showing you these queries, because this gives you an opportunity to research this, okay? So you're looking at the vector of attack, right, is equal to EP, and you can look up and see what EP, because you'll see, I want to show you this because different vectors have different designations. So this is all, we'll consider this almost like short code or a short way to designate, like if it's local, if it's remote, et cetera, right? And so then it has a severity that's equal to medium, high, and critical, and a vulnerability that's published that's older than 180 days. So you put all of these together, and that's what makes up this metric. So you can see right there's your 180 days and stuff like that. So if I look at this, this is 91 to 80 days. Okay, so if I click on that, even though it's a zero, you can click on it. And guess what I have here? Within the last 180 days and published is older than 91 days. Okay, so you can see those categories. The temporal vector is EP, right? So potentially something to do with exploit. And this is something I'll dig into. I'm actually curious. I don't know what all of these designations means. I understand it. I can easily pivot. And I just want to say, like, that's one thing that you can learn in cybersecurity. You're always going to see things that you don't know or understand. But the best skill you can have in cybersecurity is the ability to go research and figure it out and learn it and then add that to your tool bag. I also want to show this, too. These, like, exploited by malware. Because I want you to understand this temporal vector. You notice the temporal vector is EF, okay, and EH. So you can start to see, and then look at this, exploitable by malware. So let's take a look at this other one here. Okay, this one, it says remotely exploitable with low complexity. So you can see the temporal vector. So you see these different metrics are changing, right? And then the vector is equal to AVN. And based on what I've seen, this looks like it's that Nest network. But once again, I think this deserves its own video, right? So if you'd like to see a video on this, then because I want to go research it anyway, then let me know. I'll do a video on it. But anyway, this is about dashboards, but I just want you to make sure you understand that behind each part of the dashboard is a query that's serving up this information, okay? And then we get down here, we have the future threats. We talked about that. My favorite graph to use on Tenable Vulnerability Management, and this one is very good for customers right here, is the Vulnerability Age Managing SLAs. This right here is easy for a lot of people, especially me being a consultant and engineer and a pre-sales engineer and all the different hats I wear because I work for a cybersecurity startup. I like this one the most. The reason why is because this allows me to help the customer to understand. Okay, I can give them some kind of baseline. So I'm going to give you, this is not the law, but I'm just going to give you some guidance here. Okay, so what you typically want to do in your career, okay, and this is not 100% because every organization or organizations in different critical infrastructures like financial, medical, they could have different requirements. If you work for the government, it has different requirements. So this is a general rule here that say, for instance, if there's a critical vulnerability that you want those to stay within this 30 days or less, greater is equal to 30 days or less, okay? If it's a high severity, you don't want any highs that are past 60 days, okay? So I've got two that are here and the 31 to 60 days are critical. So that's out of compliance. We were considered out of compliance with our customers. For this one, if there was a high, we would say, okay, we need to watch these. We need to get these remediated before they get to 61, 90 days and they're out of compliance. And then for here, for 61 to 90 days, if it's a medium, we want to get those remediated in 90 days or less. And then lows, when you get those remediated, like in 180 days or less, like that for lows, okay? So that's just kind of got us. But once again, let's look at the query that's serving this up. Because once again, the goal here is that you will be able to create your own dashboards at some point. So if I click here on this one, let's look at the query. First seen is within the last 8 days. Severity is equal to critical. Risk modifier, which means that you can actually accept the risk or not. And we'll talk a little bit about that. That's an important part of vulnerability management. So you can kind of disregard, but a simple definition of this is if there's a vulnerability that can't remediate, then you typically want to accept the risk or you can recast it And we can say, well, maybe I don't, for my organization, this doesn't affect us as much. So it's listed as a critical, but for our organization, we consider this a medium because we have certain mitigation in place. Mitigation is basically, even though you don't have the vulnerability fixed, you have something that reduces the impact or potential impact that a vulnerability poses to your organization. Okay. State is equal to active, resurfaced, and new. So we'll get into this, but just a short definition, active means that this is something that's a vulnerability that's still there and not fixed. Resurfaced is a vulnerability that was fixed, but now it's back. And don't be fooled by this because resurfaced can also mean that the vulnerability, sometimes Tenable will use the same plugin, which is the identifier for a vulnerability. So for instance, if Chrome comes out with a new version, well, they'll reuse a identifier, a plugin ID. Like, and I don't know if Chrome is the best one. I see definitely .NET versions are .NET Core is a good example where if, you know, there's a .NET 6 vulnerability and you remediate that, but then on the same machine, they install .NET 7 and then that one gets older and then there's a vulnerability related to that. Sometimes they'll reuse the same ID, so it'll show up as resurfaced even though it's a brand new vulnerability. So I hope that's not too confusing, but I want to make sure I mention that. And then new, it was just seen. This is a new vulnerability, essentially. It's pretty self-explanatory, but there's a metric that they determine to what a new is. So when it goes from new to active, and then fixed, you don't see here because that's hidden. They hide fixed by default, but you can actually take this out and type the word fixed right here, and it will show you all the vulnerabilities that are fixed, and you can like narrow that down to this time period and stuff like that. Okay, so let's go back to the main menu. Once again, you can click on the Tenable logo here to go back to that main menu. And then we can look here. And so if I want to take a look at this, so look at this. And I want you to look, think about the query before we do it. So this is 15 to 30 days and critical. Okay, if I click on this, my query is going to say last seen within, was first seen within the last 31 days. First seen, that means the vulnerability was first discovered within the last 31 days, which includes 30 days, okay? The severity is equal to critical, we saw that. And first seen is older than 15 days. So last seen, which means that the vulnerability has to still have appeared within the last 31 days. And first seen, which means that it was, first seen is older than 15 days. So that means it was first discovered in the environment in 16, 17, 18, 19 days older than 15 days, okay? So I just want you to get used to reading this because this is a really, really important part of using Tenable is understanding the vulnerabilities. And then we have one more on the menu here. This is the scan health. This is important because when you're doing network scans, there can be fails. So no credentials provided. So that means that we have certain scans where we didn't put any credentials in. Authenticated success. That means in order for a network scan, which means you're not the host scan, which is the software on the machine, you're talking about a scan that's being done over the local network of some network of some type, and it's trying to authenticate to a computer or some device, and the authentication is either going to be successful or failure. Success, but not insufficient access. So it was a successful login, but it could also have insufficient permissions to access the device. It could be successful, but it has intermittent failure. So it doesn't succeed all the time, just sometimes. And then authentication failure for credentials, which means you have the wrong username and password or whatever authentication method you're using, and therefore it fails. So that covers this part of the dashboard, but we're not even close to finish because I at least want to show you this. And if you want me to go more in depth in dashboards, we can do that. My second dashboard that I'm a really big fan of, this is the exposure management. I love this for customers because I can use this to show over time what their vulnerabilities are doing. And so a good example is just yesterday was able to get a customer down to zero critical vulnerabilities. And we do that occasionally, but you know, it was just Microsoft Patch Tuesday. So they've released the April cumulative updates, which are patches that have to be installed every month for Microsoft. And so now they have more vulnerabilities, but at least down to zero. And you can see the graph it got here. And then it took a steep dive. Those criticals went down to nothing or two or three because it hadn't updated. It didn't show the zeros yet because it hadn't performed a scan. So, but anyway, you can see that based on this graph that the vulnerabilities went down. Now you can also see here the assets. Like I did, I used a host discovery scan right here, which means I did a scan of the network. And the difference is host discovery scan, it just detects things on your network. It doesn't assess them for vulnerabilities. And so that things that you discover with a host discovery scan are considered unlicensed, okay? Which means you don't get billed for them. So if I have like 1,000 devices, that are host discovery, but I'm not assessing them for vulnerabilities, then Tenable is not going to contact me and say, hey, you need to get a new license here because you got 1,000 devices. But the moment I assess anything in Tenable for vulnerabilities, so if I do a different type of scan on those 1,000 devices to see what vulnerabilities exist, and that gets categorized, they become licensed. And then also Tenable will say, hey, you know, you have to, now you have 1,000 devices that are licensed. You need to up your license to accommodate that 1,000 devices. So just something you need to know that's very important. And that's why it's important to manage your assets. And then this right here, this green bar, this is little scans, tells you how your scans are going. So if you start to see your scans are really, really taking a long time, that's a potential indicator of some kind of issue. So that's why this is very helpful. And that's how I use this map. So I love this view, but we're not even close to finished. I'm going to do multiple videos, but I do want to wrap this up and at least show you this, okay? Because I think this belongs in kind of the introductory part of dashboards. So we can do a new dashboard from template, and you have all these dashboards. So if you want a complete Tenable dashboard series, I think I would lose half my audience if I did go through every single dashboard. But if you want it, put it in the comments. Let me know if you do. We'll see if we can work it in and sprinkle it in here and there. Because there's lots of information. We want to make sure we look at all these and make sure you know it exists. And then you can kind of filter down. You got different groups, right? New and updated vulnerability management, web application scans. So do want you to know there. And also on this screen, but also on the main screen. So we go to dashboards. There's your button right there to create a dashboard. You can use it from the template library. Once again, what we just referenced, okay? So you can go back here and we can start building the dashboard. We can add widgets and stuff like it. Go into the library, right? And we can find these different widgets, the widget library. So widget library is a video by itself, okay? So we definitely want to do that. But last but not least, okay, we're getting close to the end. So I want to show you this. You also can hover over dashboards and you can go directly to the widget library from here, okay? And widgets are the different sections that you see on the dashboard. So keep in mind, you can make custom dashboards. And so that's why this is going to take definitely some more videos to cover this. So if this was helpful, please like the video. Please, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. If you're interested in Tenable Vulnerability Management, I'll just kind of catch these because I'm walking through Tenable comprehensively. So even if you've never touched this, you have an opportunity. And if you're still watching the video and you want to get hands-on, I do have the Cybersecurity Mentorship Program, which is geared towards not just another class, not just another boot camp. This is geared towards actually me helping you to learn the things that we do every day on the job. And you're in the tools, being able to see and click around and see things. You can't change anything. It's going to have you break an environment, but you will have access to see everything that's in the environment. I have a virtual machine set up in Google Cloud that I actually have vulnerabilities on. I have Sentinel-1, so you can do endpoint detection to see about malware and threats that are on that device. And I can open it up and infect it so you can walk through that. So I have the things in place to teach you actual cybersecurity. So if you're tired of flailing and just grabbing a whole bunch of stuff, doing a whole bunch of boot camps, and you still don't feel like you can do it, when you finish my boot camp, cybersecurity mentorship program, you will know your stuff. And all the people that have gone through, the former mentors, thank God they're still around and they actually come in and help out too and kind of walk through and share their experiences. So anyway, if that's of interest to you, then the link is in the description of the video for the cybersecurity mentorship program. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button. Thank you for the engagement. And I look forward to hearing from everybody who's watching the video.